Love this one. The power of people, purpose, and culture. Bringing high energy and excitement, it's hard not to be motivated. Pat Hayes, Adrian Rocca, and Mina Mitri give different but connected views. This charges me up. Here we go.
I think the first learning was that, was the power of culture. What the power is that it gives you, to go back to that analogy of like the field, maybe it's not the field, it's the rules of the game. It helps normalize the way that you and I are going to be with one another.
Right.
And I think a lot of times what I see happen in businesses is there always is a culture, but most of the time it happened by accident, or it kind of like very organically emerged. And I don't want to make an organically emerging culture a universally bad thing, but I think the challenge when you're not somewhat prescriptive about it and you're not choiceful and deliberate about how you want to be is you can get all kinds of things in there that you don't want to have. And I think Bridgewater, the essence of that place to me was, you know, do hard things, hold a really high bar for one another, and just be real with each other about what's working and not working. And I think that philosophy is an absolutely phenomenal way to go through life. And I like the fact that Ray Dalio, and you know, culture is absolutely an outgrowth of your founder, and you're going to see that in a lot of businesses. And I think Bridgewater is maybe the ultimate example of that. But I really appreciate the fact that he created that standard. Now, at the same time, I think that the other thing I learned is just how hard it is to maintain a culture, period. And maybe in particular, although maybe just in general, a culture like that was really difficult. And especially because a lot of it was around the importance of providing objective feedback, which many times is negative. And that's a hard thing for human beings to do. And so the effort that was put in to try and ensure that culture was permeating down to the very bottom level, I mean, it's a heavy, heavy lift.
When you're in your teens and 20s, the years feel like they go so slow. And you feel invincible and the world's never coming to an end and you're going to live forever. And as I get older, especially, you know, I'm turning 39, you know, next week. You think about mortality, the years are flying by, and I'm just very focused on not only, you know, creating a bit of a legacy, but also have a positive impact on society. You know, that's really, really important. And I feel like as these windows of opportunity to, you know, enact change or, you know, help make someone else's life better. And I don't mean to be hokey, but it truly is what drives me. I feel very fortunate that I found my passion. For some reason, even when I was in, you know, school, always loved real estate, knew I was going to get into it. And I just, you know, wake up every day being super excited to get to work and, you know, kind of build what we're building and do something special. And I tell anyone that joins our team, like, you really only join, don't do it for the comp, don't do it for anything else. Like, do it because you want to make a change and you really want to impact not only kind of what we're doing for investors, but also changing people's lives as it relates to who's living in our buildings and making sure that we could bring joy to life and a sense of pride. You know, that's what really at the end of the day drives me.
So when we hire for growth, the most important things for us are just a deep passion for the mission that we're building in Kepler. That's by far been one of the most important leading indicators of success, and people that align well with the type of ambitions we've built in the business. One of the core values we carry at Kepler is endeavoring for the 10X. And what that means is, you know, no matter what your art may be, whether your art is financial modeling or a type of radio frequency engineering, we want you to be the master of that art. And that's something that we value very deeply. And so that's the type of personality we tend to attract at Kepler.
Would you say endeavoring the 10X?
Endeavor for the 10X.
Endeavor for the 10X. That's great.
People, purpose, and culture. Dynamite.